This is the solution to written homework 32. Okay, so for part A, so we're given this one line, this one vertical line at x is 1, and all we're told is that A is something bigger than 1. So I'll just draw something over here and say that that's A, some value bigger than 1. Okay, this horizontal line is y is 0, so now we have 1, 2, 3 of the things done, and then now we want to plot 1 over x. Well, the plot of 1 over x, to remind you, is the hyperbola, the reciprocal function. It looks like this. But we're only interested in the part that's in the top right. So it looks generally like this. So this is not, the horizontal scale is not the same as the vertical scale. So it'll be like this, and then it'll be smaller here, and it'll come down. So this is the point 1, 1, because when you plug in 1 for x into there, you get y is 1, and this is the point a 1 over a. And the region that is to be rotated is this region. Okay, part B. Sketch a solid. Okay. So in this case, the solid would look like this. Okay, and this is somewhat similar to the previous exercises, except now the sides of this solid object are curvy. And if you read the hint, this part about Gabriel's horn, if I were to drag this parameter A out even further, it would start to get long and sort of be shaped like a trumpet, like a horn. Okay, so that's what it looks like. Find the volume. Okay, so then to find the volume, that will be the integral from 1 to A of pi times the radius squared dx. Okay, well, that is pi times the integral from 1 to a of 1 over x squared dx, squaring the top and bottom. But for the purposes of calculus, it is nicer to look at that 1 over x squared as x to negative 2, and then this would be pi times a to negative 1, sorry, x to, to negative 1 over negative 1, evaluated from 1 to a. So I'll spend this negative because I'd like to be rid of it, and switch the order of evaluation. So this would be pi times x to negative 1. And then from a to 1. And then, for the purposes of algebra, I like to use, instead of negative exponents, I use reciprocals. So this would be pi times 1 over x, and then from a to 1. So then, now, finally, the answer is pi times, 1 over 1 is 1, and then minus 1 over a. So this is the volume of the solid. Okay, so that's part C. And then part D is what is sort of like a what if A goes to infinity. So in this case, the picture is like we're taking this finite shape that looks something like this, and we're going to take this fence post and we're going to drag it to the side. We're going to keep pulling it out further and further and further and further. And as a result, the shape now is an infinite shape. Looks like this. So it comes out and gets infinitely fine that way. It has no end going that way. And the question is, if you the consideration about letting the limit go to infinity in this is that what if you were to take this horn that goes infinite all the way down and fill it full of water or what have you. Fill it full of water. How much water would it hold? Well, this one would hold that much water, pi times 1 minus 1 over a. So if we can compute the limit as a goes to infinity of pi times 1 minus 1 over a, pi is a constant, so it goes to itself. 1 is a constant, so it goes to itself. And then 1 over a, as a goes to infinity, that goes to 0, so minus 0. So the answer is pi. So this shape, this infinite shape that goes all the way to the right, infinitely far, infinitely pointy, going that way, has a volume of pi.